Our Creator's word testifies that he scattered the children of Israel throughout the four corners of the earth because of their rebellion to his Torah, with his statutes and his judgments. His word tells us that he gave our ancestors over to believe into lies that will not give us eternal life in his family. The lies that do not give us eternal life are the captivity of mystery Babylon. And our ancestors taught these lies to their children, and their children taught them to their children, and so on. But his word also tells us that he made his word available to us. He did so in order to call those who would choose to hearken to his word out from the captivity to return to him. His word refers to this captivity not only as mystery Babylon, but also as Egypt and Babylon. In Exodus chapter 12, verse 40, we read the habitation of the children of Israel who dwelt in Egypt was 430 years. Yahweh's word testifies that he has gathered the scattered descendants of Israel into the English-speaking countries of the world for the time of the end. It does so by testifying that he has plucked me out of the fire and sent me to the children of Israel at this time. And his word says that he has sent me to a people that speak the same language that I speak. His word says that he is going to multiply his revelations through similitudes of that which his prophets recorded at the time of the end when there would be a second Exodus. This is recorded in Hosea chapter 12. I, Yahweh Elohim, brought you from the land of Egypt. Yet again, I will make you to dwell in tents in the day of my appointed time. I have spoken through my prophets, and I will multiply my revelations through similitudes, through the hand of my prophets. He has manifested similitudes of the prophecies that are recorded in his word in a way that has testified that the United States is the head seat of the scattered nations of Israel at this time. A man sent me a narrative the other day that provides some evidence that testifies that this year, the year 5773, is the year of the second Exodus. This narrative said that Sir Humphrey Gilbert was the founder of the first English colony in North America. In 1578, Gilbert obtained the charter to plant a colony in North America that he had long sought after from Queen Elizabeth. His first attempt failed, and it cost him his whole fortune. But after further service in Ireland, he sailed again for Newfoundland in 1583. In August of that year, he took possession of the harbor of St. John and founded his colony. 2013 minus 1583 is 430 years. The third and final time that Yeshua appeared to his disciples after his resurrection, he admonished Peter three times to feed his lambs and his sheep. Then he prophesied to him that he would be girded by another and be led where he ought not to go. And he was. He fell prey to Saul of Tarsus' lies. He validated Saul, and Yahweh's word condemned Saul. After Yeshua prophesied to Peter that he would be led astray, John recorded in verse 19, Yeshua spoke this, indicating what manner of death he should glorify Elohim. And after he had spoken this, he said to him, "Follow me." He rebuked Peter to only follow him because he knew that Peter would follow another. The manner of death that Yeshua was prophesying of was referring to a death on a spiritual plane. He was referring to the death of Peter's testimony. Peter asked Yeshua, "What about John?" And Yeshua answered him, "If he desires to remain until I come, what is that to you, Peter? You follow me." You have to be willfully ignorant to not accept that Yeshua is admonishing Peter to not follow another. John even went on to say that Yeshua was not referring to a physical death. He said in verse 24, "This is the disciple who testifies of these things and wrote these things, and we know that his testimony is true." John's testimony remained true, and Peter's did not. Do you think that it is a coincidence that the first English colony that was founded was named St. John? If you do, you are delusional. Gilbert's heart's desire was to plant Christianity in North America. Therefore, his heart's desire was to plant the captivity in North America. The narrative that was sent to me was an account of Gilbert's voyage that was told by Edward Hayes, the commander of the Golden Hind. The Golden Hind was the only ship that was able to return to England from North America after St. John was founded. Is it a coincidence that Yahweh recently girded me with a golden belt? In Hayes' narrative, he said the voyage was intended to discover and to plant Christian inhabitants. His narrative was packed with things that were prophetic in nature. He spoke about their bringing Christianity to North America being for the time of the end. He said things like, "As it is conjectured by infallible arguments of the world's end approaching, They thought that their bringing Christianity to America was ushering in the time of the end, and they were correct. And this was 430 years ago this August. Is this a coincidence? Come on, people. Surely you cannot be this stubborn and stiff-necked. His narrative even used the word mystery, referring to the mystery of Elohim. Little did he know that he was, in fact, bringing the captivity of Mystery Babylon to America. He said that Newfoundland was 700 leagues from England. In Ezekiel's temple measurements, we read in chapter 48, verse 35, that the last verse of Ezekiel, it was round about 18,000 measures, and the name of the city from that day will be Yahweh is there. I was born on November 9th, 1962. This is 18,700 days from January 20th of this coming year, the last day of the great and fearful day of Yahweh's wrath. Can this really be a coincidence, people? I will be 51 years old in a few days, and this will be 21 days prior to the last 51 days. 21 days is 3/7. Yahweh has hammered the touching the dead statute with sprinkling the water of separation on the third day and the seventh day in the testimony that he has sent me to you with. His word testifies that all who are not walking with him in his word, like his son walked with him, following his son in his word, are likened to dead people before his face. And his word says that all of you who even touch the dead, who do not sprinkle with this water, are cut off from being his people. Why can't you believe his word? The fact that Gilbert founded St. John in August is also fascinating. August is 5 months from the great and fearful day of Yahweh's wrath. His wrath will be in these 5 months. It is not a coincidence that the fifth trumpet prophecy is for 5 months of torment. The incredible design in how the Most High has funneled the prophecies that are recorded in his word into the 7 days that follow the beginning of the 11th month of the year 5773 is nothing short of phenomenal. These 7 days will be from January 13th to January 20th on the calendar that Satan's children use. In Revelation 18:4, my people, come out from Mystery Babylon so that you are not partakers of her sins and so that you do not receive of her calamity. Thus saith Yahweh Elohim.